Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to another new video on my channel Train Teacher, and today we're driving on the Munich route track. So we're driving from Munich East Station to one station after Munich Main Station. And yeah, we are here in Bavaria, Bavaria, Germany. This is the capital city of Bavaria, Munich. And yeah, I would say that we start in this introduction. Which is written in German. It only says that we should activate our safety systems, and we're driving this City Train 6 to into the direction of Munich Pasing, and that the timetable is very hard. And yeah, let's see if we can challenge this timetable and if we're about to be on time. So enough talked, we're opening the doors. Doors are opened, reverser put it in forward. And yeah, let's see what happens today. So we're activating the CIFA, the PZB safety system, and the LZB, because today we're driving in LZB surveillance. It says, yeah, you know, usually it's used, the LZB, on long distance tracks or used for speeds or just in general for fast trains which are driving faster than 165 kilometers per hour. And the LZB signalizes the signal of the next 10 kilometers, or all signals of the next 10 kilometers here into the cab with this bar into the middle. And yeah, you know that the city train isn't driving with more than 165 kilometers per hour, so it only drives like 80 or 100, or in some areas, or after leaving Munich, the area of Munich, going into some pre-villages or something of Munich. There you can drive up to 130 or something like this. But they use here on the route track, I call it route track in Germany, it's called Stammstrecke. And we're going now into the underground of Munich. But on this route track, they use LZB2 to realize a very hard and, yeah, very tight tacted timetable, or very tight tacked, even, let's say it like this, to realize a lot of trains in just 1-2 minutes. There's train coming every 1-3 minutes, so they use LZB because it's easier to make this timetable work, this timetable here, because with the LZB the distance between two trains can be reduced. And with normal PZB it isn't possible. So let's check if the doors are closed, because you see the T light is blinking constantly. So we're going out, everything's fine, and we are about to drive. And yeah, just as an additional information, oh no, where I stopped, I think there was no additional information, but yeah, with the LZB the normal signals are not that important anymore. You have to always look at them, but they're not that important. And in a doubt or something like this, the LZB signalization into the cab is always the one which the driver will follow in a doubt. And usually or normally the signals here along the route, right, you can see now we're entering the LZB. The signals along the route are, or along the track, are normally here turned off during LZB, and they're turned off. A second condition is that they have to turn.
Halt, Rosenheimer Platz.
That they turned off.
Aufstieg zum Deutschen Museum. Next stop, Rosenheimer Platz. A light here for the Deutsches Museum. Bitte links aussteigen. Please exit the train on the left.
Yeah, and I just wanted to say another important condition is that the train in front of you reduces its distance to you, or the distance to the train in front of you is so much reduced that they're just about 100 meters away. Sometimes in reality, you can, if you're driving here with the LZB system, the train driver of like us can see the end of the next train into the next station if the view is allowing this, and that's very interesting. And this is only realizable with the LZB system. So as I already told you, it's important here to, or in general, to sum it up, It's important the SZB system here to realize the tight timetables of every train here and to make a real tact. And in addition to that, the SZB system is used to reduce the distance between two trains, and yeah, the SZB signalizes the whole signals into the cab. And sometimes if the distance to the next train in front of you reduces so hard that the signalization, the normal signalization, would show red because it says the area in front of you is blocked, then they turn it off, so the signal don't show any signal or any color anymore, and it just, the LZB shows here something to you and says if you can drive or not. And that's, I hope you understood it. If you don't understood it, just write it into the comments and then I will explain it to you in another new video. And yeah, so let's see. Oh, okay, we're not on time. We already messed it up. Our first stop is we couldn't
Isar Tor. Ausstieg zum Deutschen Museum. Next stop, Isar Tor. A light here for the Gasteig. Bitte links aussteigen. Please exit the train on the left.
Yeah, the first stop, yeah, we messed it up because we were already too late, so we can't get the scenario anymore as on time. Very sad, but I just know where my fault was. I just talk too much. I just wanted to explain it to you, you know. I like it if you understand it too, what I say. So, yeah, that was my only intention. And now we messed it up a bit, so it's just like this, don't worry. So let's take a look out of here. That's our nice train. We are driving with the BR-423, the common or mainly used trains on the route track. Okay, doors are closed, so we are leaving Munich Isar Tor. And from now on we are allowed to drive 80. If the end of our train passed this speed marker. And now we are allowed to drive 80. Nice. But it isn't very useful because for us, because you see we have to break down again onto 60.
Marienplatz. Umstieg zur U3 und U6. Lift in Fahrtrichtung links. Next stop, Marienplatz. Change here for the U3 and U6. Bitte rechts aussteigen. Please exit the train on the right.
Okay. And now we're stopping here. Doors are opened again. So let me check my OBS recording if everything's working. Yeah, everything's working fine. Very good. So here's the entrance of the train, and on the other side here, the passengers are forced to leave it here on this side. Okay, doors are closed, and now we're accelerating for Karlsplatz, the next stop. Oh, we're not on time. That good, we have 1 minute of delay. We're having a 1 minute delay, so.
Nächster Halt, Karlsplatz Stachus. Umstieg zur U4 und U5. Lift in Fahrtrichtung links. Next stop, Karlsplatz Stachus. Change here for the U4 and U5. Bitte links aussteigen. Please exit the train on the left.
I'm honest with you guys. we couldn't do the challenge so good. I'm sorry, but I think it's not a big problem that we are just 1 minute delayed, because I have to be honest, I just like it to drive it here. And yeah, I'm very happy that you're here today. Thank you for being here, and I hope you enjoyed still. So, then let's check if the doors are getting closed now. Yeah, doors are closing from now on. And we're accelerating. We got a little bit breakdown.
Halt, Hauptbahnhof. Umstieg zum Regional- und Fernverkehr sowie zur U1, U2, U4 und U5. Lift in Fahrtrichtung links. Next stop, Munich Central Station. Change here for regional and long distance services and for the U1, U2, U4 and U5. Bitte rechts aussteigen. Please exit the train on the right.
Okay, and now we're here, Munich Main Station, underground station of Munich Main Station, I mean. And the next stop is Hackerbrücke, in English Hacker Bridge. And there we are about to... Oh, we got one station on time. Nice. Okay, cool. So there we have Munich Underground, Munich Main Station Underground, and... The next stop, Hacker Bridge, where is our journey ending? Yeah, for today. And maybe we will drive in another video here again on time, my friends. Okay, doors are getting closed now. Doors are closed, and we're about to accelerate. There's another colleague. I don't know why it's so loud now and echoing here. But I think it was just a marker which was set badly for the voice effects. Okay, and now we have to stop at the second H, because we're a full train and not a long train. A full train is with two tractions, a short train one traction, and the long train, there's written Langzug, it means in English long train, three units. Yeah, so my friends, I hope you enjoyed this little ride into the Munich Underground, or the Munichian Underground, I don't know how we say it in English correctly, in the underground of Munich, let's say it like this. I really enjoyed it, and I would be very happy if we see each other soon in another new video. Then I think the next video will be a ride with an ICE. And yeah, let's see how you like it. We'll see each other soon. Take care, and thanks for watching today. Our train is leaving the station now for you, and leave a comment and leave a like if you want to. I hope you stay healthy. Goodbye.